Hello everyone, this is Mr. Erection, and this is just a little video to show off my build for Outpost Zimonja. This video is going to be a little bit different than most of the build videos that you find for Fallout 4, because this is one that you can actually have yourself. If you're anything like me, you watch videos from a lot of the really fantastic builders that are out there, and you go, oh my god, I could never have something set up like that. That just seems like way too much time and effort, and even if I, you know, studied this, chances are I wouldn't be able to get it the same way that they've got. So, just to give you a little bit of a heads up, this one's not like that. You can have this exact settlement. So, this is part of a mod that myself and a lot of other builders are working on called Growing Settlements. It allows you to capture a settlement like normal, but instead of building it up yourself, the settlers that you attract are going to work together to build up the base bit by bit while you're away. Each level has a requisite population requirement, and once you've reached that and then left for a preset period of in-game time, you can come back and see that the settlers will have completed a level, which equates to them having built various additions to support more settlers and or increasing the defense or resources to that base. So once you've gotten enough settlers there to meet the next population requirement, process starts all over again for the next level, and so on till the base is finished. This is going to be applicable to almost all of the settlements available in the Commonwealth. So unfortunately, not going to be available for Far Harbor or with if there's any settlements that are added in on Nuka World. Honestly, I don't know, because I haven't gotten a chance to play around with that a bit yet. So, each one of these bases is going to be unique, and it's going to grow at its own rate, depending on how long it's been since you've captured that individual settlement, and how quickly it attracts new settlers. This is one of the most ambitious mods that I have ever seen on the Nexus, and it attempts to offer something of an out to the people who like Fallout 4, but just aren't fans of the whole building aspect to it. The reason that I'm posting this is because we're looking for some additional builders to make the last few settlements that we have available. We do ask that no items that are found outside of vanilla or DLC assets, please. We prefer to have people who have established themselves as builders on YouTube to help drum up some support and promote the project, but we are willing to consider anyone who's got a unique style and can deliver a high quality design. And understand that when I say we, I don't mean me. I am but a humble settlement builder here. I'm not one of the bigwigs with this mod or anything like that, so just so you are aware, that's where we're at. By the way, I'm gonna fix that before you guys get it, so yeah, you won't have a little gap there. Anyways, let's go in and take a peek. So my idea with the settlement was, well, I'll get back to that in a minute. First off, this is the original setup that you had here, just the little guard post and that bridge up there. So you've got a place where you can actually come up here and be able to kind of take pot shots at people coming in. This switch is going to be for that gate as well. It's basically this one or the one that's on the outside can open it. So you can open it for people who are coming in. You want to set up your trade caravan, trading caravan post over here or something like that. You can have it there and you can actually let the folks in. This heavy machine gun turret over here is just a replacement for the one that you take out when you first actually take the settlement yourself. And over here, we've got our water supply. Start off with one of these water pumps, and then as you go up in levels, then it adds the second water pump there. And then it'll add in these two electric pumps at later levels and connect them up. Put in a large generator here and just kind of close that in so you don't have to worry so much about, you know, raiders coming over here and blowing your stuff up. Added in this nice windmill. Really like how that came together. As Davey would say, I'm rather chuffed about it. we've got a armor stand here. These are probably not going to be able to be upgraded within the mod itself, just because we want to make sure that, you know, everybody has access to this. So, in order for you to be able to upgrade these, basically you would need to have the requisite perks, and then you could just delete this and replace it with the level 2 or level 3 stands accordingly. So let's go up, and I'm going to start off by showing you guys the garage. This is a power armor garage, because the basic idea behind this settlement was this is supposed to have been set up right after the Brotherhood of Steel comes in with a big airship and everything like that. This is the Minuteman response to that. Group of people that they're sending up here to be trained to be power armor pilots and mechanics. So we've got, for every one of these displays here, we've got a corresponding workshop. So if it's ready to go, then it goes in the display. If it's needing to be worked on, then it goes over here in one of these. This is our power armor response team. And because, you know, running around in a suit all day is tough work. Come over here. Get shit-faced. Because, yeah, that's what I really want. Somebody running around in a giant robot suit blowing shit up. Who is hammered at the time. Yeah, that's fun. So, that is our garage up there. We got a couple more suits. This is our barracks, dormitory, living quarters, whatever you want to call it. Got a little seating area over here. Watch some TV. We need to get these guys set up with some cable. That's kind of sad. Sleeping areas, storage for everybody. And if we come over here, go downstairs, and we can see the mess hall, kitchen, just sink, stove. Some storage, place for people to sit and eat. You'll notice that this settlement is a little bit light on the clutter decorations, and that's kind of by design. We wanted to make it where the building itself is set up, but you can go in and personalize it yourself so that it fits, so that it looks like your settlement. But you don't have to actually go and build everything for it. So we're going to come over here, and as you can see here, this is our weapons shop. I didn't see nobody there yet, but that's okay. And in here we've got some armor, weapons, and chemistry work sets, workbenches. We've got some display racks for weaponry, and since this is actually built into the wall that goes around this whole settlement, we've also got a little setup here, so you flip that switch and have a heavy laser turret there to mow anybody down who's dumb enough to come over here and install some shit. This is the weapons shop. We've got a place for a couple of sleeping quarters, storage, some more storage over here, so the folks who are actually working on these areas have got a place to crash in between, and we've got somebody there to man the wall, as it were. Got a few, I'll just come over here and let you take a peek at this. So, we've got a couple of, spotlight, another heavy machine gun turret, and if you look down here, you can see we've also got a missile launcher and spotlight over here, just for some extra defense on this. So, run back down here, and over here is our clinic. So, we've also got, if we open this up, a little place for our doctor, medic, whatever, to be able to crash in between selling you whatever mind-altering substances you want to purchase from them. Remember, kids, drugs are bad. Okay. And up here we also have this is where our artillery is gonna go. Now the reason why I don't have any artillery here right now is just because I'm playing this with a low B character, because all of my regular characters are using a bunch of mods, which does not work with the way that we're setting this up. So, yeah. Unfortunately, had to make a new character. He's only, like, level 2 or 3, something like that. So, yeah. No, haven't captured the castle yet with this particular one. So, yeah. That's why there's no artillery up there. But, Eskarn, the... oh, so our benevolent leader of this modding group, he's gonna go ahead and add that in there himself, so I'll let him do that. And this is the one of the bedrooms that are already kind of set up when you come and capture the settlement in the first place. We just spruced it up a bit. Gave you some bunk beds here. All of these bunk beds, by the way, are usable both top and bottom by the settlers, so you know, no more of that the bunk beds where, you know, they only sleep on the bottom or something like that and then complain to you about, oh, we gotta sleep in ships. Yeah, none of that crap. We have another heavy machine gun turret here, and a heavy laser turret over here to cover this little area over here, because if you're like me, most people, when they first come to capture this, just park yourself up there, and you can take pot shots at all the raiders that originally have this settlement. You can kind of just shoot at them from up there and not have to worry about getting hit. So, this is the other bedroom that is here by default, and we just, again, spruced it up a little bit, fixed the walkways here all the way around, and this brings us back to the dormitory area Just wanted to have a couple of other power armor displays and workshops here. Figure that this is probably for, you know, the officers or something of the group. Then we come down here. Bathroom. Outhouses. Because, yeah, it drives me nuts when I see somebody put together a beautiful settlement and then no bathroom. Just, I guess, the OCD realist in me coming out, and I'm just like, oh my god, I can't stand to wait 5 minutes on somebody else for the bathroom. These people don't even have one. 20, 30 people, and they're just, you know, going in, taking a squat in the corner or something. Got another heavy machine gun here, and a spotlight. Both of them are covering that little corner over there again. And we also have this little boxcar guard tower here. Same sort of setup as we had over on the wall. This one has a rocket launcher instead, though. So, yeah, just open that up. Automatically activates that and gives anybody who is dumb enough to come after this settlement, gives them a face full of rocket. Come over here and you can take pot shots at any raiders that are dumb enough to come up here and try to take a shot at you. And we also have another little outpost area like that over here. Just a place for him to hang out and take a nap. He'd been doing this for a little bit, you know, end of a long shift. So, yeah, that is pretty much my whole build here for Outpost Zimonja. And this is my pitch video for Growing Settlements mod. If you're interested in helping us out with this one, then the settlements that we still have available will be listed in the description, as well as contact information for Eskarn, who, like I said before, is the head of our little group here. And he's the one who's got the final say over, you know, whether or not you actually get in. Not me, sorry. But yeah, if you like what you see here, like, subscribe, share, all that fun stuff. Send me money on Patreon so that I can just play around on Fallout all day instead of doing, you know, regular work crap, because who wants to do that? I'm also going to be uploading some more videos here in the next couple of weeks or so. Some other settlements that I have done that unfortunately are not going to be included within Growing Settlements, just because, you know, those are ones that I built that have way too many mods in there. But yeah, so if you like this, feel free to share it or contribute if you want. We appreciate all the help we can get. So, thanks. Have a good one.